Portland, Oregon, especially, we had more than 100 straight days of protests, which I think you would agree, you talk about peaceful protests, many of those turned into riots. Mr. Vice President, you say that people who commit crimes should be held accountable. The question I have, though, is, as the Democratic nominee, and earlier tonight you said that you are the Democratic Party right now, have you ever called the Democratic mayor of Portland or the Democratic governor of Oregon and said, hey, you got to stop this, bring in the National Guard, do whatever it takes, but you stop the days and months of violence in Portland?
I don't hold public office now. I am a former vice president. I've made it clear. I've made it clear in my public statements that the violence should be prosecuted. It should be prosecuted, and anyone who commits it should be
prosecuted. But you've never called for the people, the leader, excuse me, sir, you had never called for the leaders in Portland and in Oregon to call and bring in the National Guard and knock off 100 days of riots.
They can, in fact, take care of it if he just stay out of the way. Look here.
Oh, really?
Here's the thing.
I sent in the U.S. Marshals to get the killer of the young man in the middle of the street. They shot him. And for 3 days,
President Trump wouldn't do anything.
I had to send in the U.S. Marshals. They took care of business.
Go ahead, sir.
And by the way, you know, his own former spokesperson said, you know, riots and chaos and violence help his cause. That's what this is all about.
I don't know who said that.
I do.
Who?
I think Kellyanne Conway.
I don't think she said that.
She said that. And so here's the here's the point.
The point is
that's what he is keeps trying to rile everything up. He doesn't want to calm things down. Instead of going in and talking to people and saying, let's get everybody together, figure out how to deal with this. What's he do? He just pours gasoline in the fire constantly and every single solitary time.
Okay, and to end this, button up this segment, I'm going to give you a minute to answer, sir. You have repeatedly criticized.
I have to answer his statement.
You've been talking back and forth.
He made a statement.
I'm asking you.
I would love to end it. If you want to switch seats.
We could do that, but I'd send in
the National Guard. It would be over. There'd be no problem.
Okay.
But they don't want to accept the National Guard.
You have repeatedly criticized the vice president for not specifically calling out Antifa and other left-wing extremist groups. But are you willing tonight to condemn white supremacists and militia groups and to say that they need to stand down and not add to the violence in a number of these cities, as we saw in Kenosha and as we've seen in Portland?
Sure,
are you prepared to specifically
do it? I would say almost everything I see is from the left wing, not from the right wing.
So what are you saying?
I'm willing to do anything. I want to see peace.
Then do it, sir.
Say it.
Do you want to call him? What do you want to call him? Give me a name.
White supremacists and right wing.
Proud Boys. Stand back and stand by, but I'll tell you what. Somebody's got to do something about Antifa and the left, because this is not a right-wing problem.
This is a left-wing problem. Antifa's an idea, not an organization.
Oh, you got it.
Not militia. That's what FBI director
Gentlemen,
said.
Well, then you know what?
We're done, sir. We're moving on to the next.
Everybody, we're moving on to the next.